Because the speaker tells like everybody will have a problem, but only some people will win against the problem and some people will lose and the problem will win. Okay, so what is the difference between people who win against the problem and the people who lose? Okay, so he has mentioned about some 12 to 16 principles which I will be telling about, like when you have a problem, like how do you handle it and what are the things you take into consideration to overcome the problem. So I thought, okay, he shared one story. Robert Schuller, he is a founder of Crystal Cathedral, and that Crystal Cathedral is worth millions of dollars, which he established. But when he started, it was not like that. It was very small. Like, he had a small idea. But the dream was very powerful. But the problem was, when he started with a small church, it can occupy only some 500,000 people. So he wanted to impact more people. So he thought of increasing the size of the church. But the problem was, some technical difficulties, like people who come, they want to park their cars, all these small problems, right? He had that issue. So he thought, okay, he spent another few million dollars. It took some more years of time. And he increased the size of the church. So like when he didn't have anything also, he had a problem. But when he started the church also, he had a different problem. Okay, it may not be the same problem. So when he wanted to accommodate some 3,000 or 4,000 plus people, right? He had a different problem altogether. So at every stage, right, Robert Schuller, even though he was founder of worth millions of dollars of the church, there were some problems. So like he gives some principles which I'm going to share. So first one is like every human being has a problem. We need to understand that we are not unique, or some people think like, okay, he is happy and I'm the person who is having a problem. It's not like that. And every problem has a limited lifespan. We need to understand that it's tentative. Problem is not permanent. Okay. Third one is like every problem holds positive possibilities. We think about, we usually tend to think about negative possibilities, but it also has positive possibilities. Okay. And we need to let the problem changes. If we don't change, the problem will be the same. So we need to raise above the problem so that we can tackle the problem. And the next one is, okay, you need to choose what the problem can create, what is the impact that it can create on you. And the last one is a negative and positive reaction. There's a negative and positive reaction to every problem. Some people tend to see the negative reaction, negative side, and some people tend to see the positive side. Okay, so I thought, okay, let me share a small story about myself. Maybe around 8 years back, I started a small startup. Okay. So, starting a startup or a venture is a cool thing in Bangalore, okay? But when you start something, it's always small, okay? Initial, like, 3-4 years, me and my team, who I was associated with, like-minded professionals, I thought then, it was very good, right? Okay? When 3-4 years, it was very good. But after 4 years of starting it, it started shaking. There are so many companies, startups start in Bangalore, but not all will succeed. Maybe 5 years, 10 years, only 2-3% of that will succeed. So, but why the others fail? Have you ever thought about that? So only when you start something, you will tend to know. So when there was some leadership issues with the team, if I'm working in some software company, and if the company where I work for, if the company doesn't have a mission or a vision where it is going, as an employee, do you feel scared? So I will feel like, okay, what will my job, what is it? Okay, we are dependent on one source of income, whether that will be there or it will be gone. What will happen to the company? What will happen to me? What will happen to my family? So we tend to think of all these things. So even if there is some negative things, our leadership management, okay, they don't disclose anything, right? It will be all of a sudden. So something like this, leadership issues happen, like and the venture started to fall. So what I had invested a lot of energy, a lot of my time, some money also, all that. But still, I cannot, when the situation happened, it was emotionally making me weak. But I cannot turn away from the problem. Like, I need to handle it. So that's where, like, I, after trying for 2-3 years, whatever, I can drive all the solutions, right? I wrote it down. I thought of all that. I started implementing it, but I could not get out of it. That's why, like, Speak Impact mentorship program from Vijay, I really got connected and related, because I didn't have mentorship to grow. How to, when there is a problem, how to handle it, how to tackle it, how to overcome it. We need somebody to guide us, mentor us. Okay, that one was missing. So I need, go through all these principles, which you can implement it when you have a problem. Okay, don't underestimate it. Don't exaggerate it. Don't wait for the problem to resolve by itself. Okay, don't aggravate it. Okay, illuminate, motivate yourself. Okay, and have a date so that, okay, if you want to give something to it, if you want to change something, and sublimate and dedicate yourself how to resolve it, how to overcome it. Communicate with, take help of some people who, communicate to them who can help you. Okay, it's not like they can take energy from out of you, not like that. And insulate yourself, okay, with positive stuff. And I think I was sharing about this, how to handle it positively, and you'll definitely find out positive possibilities. And that's how I landed up in Big Impact Mentorship. Okay, thank you. Thanks for giving me.
Thank you, Patrick. Awesome.
Nice, Karthik. Ravinder Mishra, you have raised your hand. So, would you like to go next?
No, today's my first day. My name is Ravinder.
Okay.
I was invited in this group by... 1 minute, huh? I was invited in this group...
Can you turn on your video?
1 moment. Sorry, I'm not getting that option in.
Ravindra, what you do is in your screen, in the bottom left side, you will see two options. One is for audio and one is for video. Did you find it?
Actually, I joined it with mobile. I didn't join with
mobile only.
Text.
Mobile, there will be a screen where, you know, you'll be able to see one blank screen. Na? There'll be a board actually, how the way currently the screen is spotlight, right? So, mm-hmm. In which screen are you? In the chat box or in the main screen?
No, I mean, I'm not getting it. 1 minute. Just give me a minute.
Sure. No issues. I think we can give you the option. Just a second.
One moment.
You'll get a pop-up.
Okay. Now am I visible to you?
Yeah, you're visible.
Okay. So, my name is Ravindra and I was being added in this group by Bhushan. Via LinkedIn.
Awesome, Ravindran. And where do you stay? Where do you work?
I'm basically a Bangalorean. I'm from Bangalore only. And I work for LTI as a software developer. Actually, I raised my hand to know the name of the book which the last reader was talking of.
It's that the book name is Tough Time Never Lasts, But Tough People Do by Robert Schuller. We'll just post the names and all in the chat box, Ravindra. You can just go through that then.
Okay. Okay, thank you.
Okay, he can ask the questions then.
Yeah, and in case you have any questions, you can also ask in the chat box.
Sure.
Cool. I think Chachu is ready.
Kiran, can I share my screen?
Yeah, sure. Just a second, we'll spotlight you.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Good evening, everyone. So my name is Dilip Gupta. I'm joining from Pune. So I've been the part of this book club from the beginning. So actually today I wanted to talk about the 21 irrefutable laws of leadership. So one of those laws, that is the law of inner circle. So it law of inner circle talk about a leader and a leader's potential is determined by those closest to him. What does it mean? Closest to him in the sense jo leader hai उसका लीडर, वो लीडर के लिए ऑल दोज पीपल हु आर क्लोज टू हिम, दोज हु आर वर्किंग अलोंग विद हिम. ओके, सो इफ सपोज इफ आई एम ए लीडर, आई हैव टू प्रूव माय पोटेंशियल. इन दैट केस हु आर ऑल द पीपल क्लोज टू मी, दैट इज डिटरमाइंड बाय माय पोटेंशियल. ओके, सो सपोज I'm heading a project. As you all know, I'm heading a project. Suppose I'm a delivery manager, and under me there are three leaders. Again, for region, if you can see my screen, region A there is another leader. Region B is headed by one more leader. And region C is headed by third leader. So actually, we had a similar case. I'm giving this example because we had a similar case in our company. The General Motors was the project we were working, and I was the leader in region A, and several others people, leaders, sub leaders also were there in region B and C. What happened? So we started this project. We started this project with the region A, that is US, and we started working together. And under me, I had 4 to 5 people, and I was closely working on those people. Now we started our complete account started growing. My leader is the delivery manager for the complete General Motors account. And once we started working together, slowly we started growing, and we started region B and we started region C. And what happened? Finally, like, we keep on adding one more region. Suppose it is northern US, southern US, and those kind of things. So what it makes? What happened when we started working? My delivery manager's potential was determined by the V people, the region, the leaders from the region A, region B, and region C. Why it is happening? See, you know, one person, the delivery manager, akela wo kaam, agar whatever wo kaam karega, but that will not be like, yeah, agar hum log, sab log usko support nahi karenge, to he is not going to get the success. So the irrefutable laws of growth means the law of inner circle says that a leader's potential is determined by those closest to him. So leaders like region A, region B, and region C are closely working with the delivery manager, and if they work properly, they are able to lead their people. And as a whole, all the team will be part of the success that the delivery manager is getting. So there are a few points. Just I will say how a delivery manager get the success. If their leaders, sub leaders like me, and region A, region B, and region C, if they are able to influence their own team. And if they bring additional benefit to the complete team as a whole, and the sub leaders also should have their own strategy, and they should be in a better position with the company and to get the success. Okay, these are all the qualities a leader should have. If my team is doing performing well, the delivery manager will be able to perform much better. And this is what happened. We had similar issues also. Some team were not able to do well, and some team were able to do well. And those people working with the delivery manager, if they get success, the main leader, the delivery manager, is going to get the success. And this is what the law of inner circle says. And I summarize here, the law of inner circle says that nobody alone can work to get success. If a leader is successful, then definitely the team with work whom he is working, the inner circle with whom he is working, they should be successful.
Awesome, Chachu. It was a great hearing.
Thank you.
I think just to add one Chachu sharing, I think actually very tricky question as well. आपके अगर ऑफिस में अगर आप नोटिस करोगे कितने लोग अपने सीईओ के साथ खाना खाते हैं, कितने लोग अपने यू नो मैनेजर या फिर वीपी या डायरेक्टर के साथ यू नो मिलकर चाय पीते हैं. एक्चुअली इफ यू सी यू नो वी ऑल आर प्रोडक्ट ऑफ आवर ओन इनर सर्कल एंड इफ यू रियली वांट टू ग्रो आप अभी ऑब्जर्व करना कि योर सर्कल विल कीप ऑन चेंजिंग एज लॉन्ग एज यू आर ग्रोइंग इन योर कॉर्पोरेट और इन योर लाइफ एज वेल. द बेस्ट एग्जांपल इज दैट वी वांटेड टू क्रिएट दिस मास्टरमाइंड अलायंस फॉर आवर सेल्फ. Peak Impact Mentorship Book Club is one of the examples where you know we're creating our own inner circle for growth. Awesome, Chachu. Bahut achha sharing kiya tha. In fact, you took so much of time to showcase this presentation as well. Really good. Awesome.
Thank you, Kiran.
Great. So, in the chat.
We have Asha and the new people, right? Asha and me.
You change the spotlight.
Yeah, make it. You can move, Chachu. Yeah.
This one. Sorry.
Okay.
So, microphone. Awesome. Is my voice audible? It's audible, right? Sound aa raha hai? Do you see any?
Yes, Kiran. It's audible.
Perfect. You can actually check this green color if I speak. It's audible, right? Awesome. Actually, I couldn't stop myself. I was so excited. People are speaking so awesome. So I thought, you know, I'll just share my learning as well. So short journey, you know, the time when we started our book club, it all started with because of Vijay. With his weekend workshop and so much of responses, so much of an enthusiasm we heard from people, and that is when you know Vijay gave us the idea to you know start book club in pockets to pockets across India as well, taki you know we all can follow through our learnings, whatever we are learning in you know weekly basis, and start applying to them. And the biggest learning which you know I started applying was you know last few book clubs I was talking on goals, right? I started with this theory of you know Harvard Business School. If you guys remember, right, we thought you know the people who are graduating from Harvard Business School and the statistics of people who graduated after with goals, without goals, and overall we you know summarized and we found out ki 3% log jinhone apna goal banaya tha you know graduate hone se baad aur jo goal banane se matlab graduate hone se pehle baad mein aur usko follow karte gaye 10 saal ke baad they could actually create wealth combinedly 97% of the remaining people, and that was truly astonishing. So the moment you know I started learning the book called Goals, I started applying to my you know life as well. And the beauty is that jab aap goal ko aap life mein apply karte ho, you actually feel so happy because har roz aapke liye ek nayi cheez hoti hai, har roz aapko excitement feel hota hai. And we started you know working on how to set goals. Humne ye bhi sikha ki goal ko set kaise karte hain. It has to be concrete, it has to be you know aligned with your character, it has to be you know clear, definite, and also it has to have deadline as well. To sab kuch humne define kar diya. Next, uske baad humne ye bhi sikha ki you know ultimately agar goals ko hum log apne dreams or aspirations se relate kaise karenge, because goals is something you know it helped us to execute something in reality. We also learned ultimate jo bhi dreams hai, we connected them into you know money and time. And through money and time, we you know connected to with our goals, and we also learned about concept called effort attention, which I you know talked in the last time as well. You know, aam ka ped or paddy crop, if you all remember, right? Aaj main aisi cheez share karne wala hu. It is too good. Agar aap life ke kisi bhi you know jagah pe ho, kisi bhi saath mein ho, kabhi aapne socha hai ki kuch cheezein jab bhi koi baat karta hai, aapke dimag mein chipak jata hai. You know, that ideas or any words which people say it sticks. If you see any movie or, you know, if you see any good movie, whatever you feel like, or, you know, sometimes the ads and everything is so impactful ki aap use bhool bhi nahi sakte. In fact, kuch ads ko agar TV mein dekhoge to aapko lage yaar ye to kitna achha ad, aur baad mein jab end mein pata chalta hai kaun brand hai, then thoda humko unexpected wali feeling hoti hai, right?
I am going to talk about fundamental key, how to make your idea stick. And the best part is that, so there was friend of mine. So what happened was, you know, he used to travel across the country and mostly on business visits. So bahut zyada business visit karte rehta tha. And ek bar wo kya kiya, ek bar wo Delhi se Mumbai travel kar raha tha. And Delhi se Mumbai travel kiya, everything was so good. And the problem was flight got delayed. Flight delay ho gaya. To wo socha ki chalo ab kya kare, you know, time pass karte hain thoda bahut. And he went to, jaise hi wo Mumbai, you know, airport mein land karke, he went out and went to a bar. Socha ki, you know, I'll have a drink. And he sat there, baith ke apna drink pi raha tha, one glass he drank as well. And the moment he was drinking, you know, just 10 feet away, there was a lady, you know, with a red gown. And she was too beautiful. And, you know, she comes to that guy closer and she offers him a drink. So, and, you know, and generally, you know, people, if you are a guy, then, you know, obviously you would say no to a drink. I mean, lady is offering. So she went to the bar, you know, went to the cellar again. She got two glasses of wine and then, you know, she offered a drink. And this is the last thing that guy remembered. Actually, after he you know, woke up, he found out ki ye banda was, you know, somewhere in some bathtub lying. And the moment he, you know, woke up, he saw a small you know, slip lying just beside him, aur usme likha tha call 911. Oh, guy, well, the guy was so scared. Uska, you know, pura badan pura thand se tha. It's like, you know, aap soch ke dekho, aapke body mein pura ice dal ke rakha hua hai. Matlab bahut jam gaya aapka body. And wo bahut hi mushkil se gaya, apne phone ko uthaya aur 911, you know, dabaya. Jaise hi 911 usne call kiya, to the surprising fact was that wo police ko call kar raha hai. Police bhi relax se baat kar rahi hai. Wo bol rahi hai ki I think if you're calling from that place, can you please, you know, move back and see whether you have a tube attached. Or darya tube ka attached ho dekha. There was a, you know, short tube attached from his body and it was connected somewhere. And it was, and a lady tells ki, don't move at all. Actually, there have been lots of kidney harvesters roaming across the city. So aapka kidney chori ho chuka hai ek. Please, you know, move mat hona. You know, and stay wherever you are. Paramedics aa rahe hain aapko pick karne ke liye. What happened after that? Fundamentally, what happened? The story, which is quite simple, right? Actually, the story was to communicate an idea where kidney harvesters are, you know, floating around, just like how coronavirus is floating around right now. Just to give you an idea, the story which I just shared, kidney harvester, ye story dekhna kabhi bhool bhi nahi paoge. Kyun? Fundamentally, the story had few components, which I'll just write down and you can also note it down. And any idea, if you can, you know, bring that idea or your message in that component, your idea, your communication will be super powerful. In fact, people will never forget those ideas. The first, you know, was the idea ka pehla acronym hai. I covered also initially. S-U-C-C-E-S. S ka matlab simple. Now, if you see in the story of, you know, kidney heist, the message is very, very, you know, core. The core message of this, you know, story is what? Ki basically, we want to educate. There are people who are, you know, who could be dangerous to you. So be careful in the market, right? Ab us message mein basically kya chal raha hai? Simple mein aage tumhara core. If you want to communicate any idea to anyone, best is to find out what is the core of the idea. अगर आप किसी स्मोकिंग के टॉपिक में बात कर रहे हो, तो आपको पता होना चाहिए कि आपका कोर मैसेज क्या जा रहा है उस टॉपिक में. एंड उस मैसेज के अराउंड आप एक कंटेंट प्रिपेयर करो विच कुड बी कॉम्पैक्ट एंड विच इज वेरी इजी टू अंडरस्टैंड विद पब्लिक, राइट? इन आवर केस, इन माय केस, विच आई शेयर्ड, डेफिनेटली यू नो द सिनेरियो जो मैंने शेयर किया, इट इज लिटिल एक्साइटिंग ऑल्सो, थोड़ा अनएक्सपेक्टेड भी हो गया. और यू नो, लड़की भी आती है, अच्छी सुंदर लड़की आ रही है, तो कोई और कुछ और सोच रहा है. सडनली यू नो, वो बंदा बाथरूम पे जाग रहा है. तो सो मेनी थिंग्स आर देयर एंड द मैसेज ऑल्सो पासेस. तो ओवरऑल मेरा जो कोर मैसेज था, किडनी वाला मैसेज, वो पास हो गया. एंड द स्टोरीज आर क्वाइट कॉम्पैक्ट, कोई बड़ा स्टोरी नहीं है. एंड इट इज नॉट डिफिकल्ट टू यू नो रिमेम्बर ऑल्सो. द नेक्स्ट इज अनएक्सपेक्टेड. If you saw, suddenly what happened, you know, everything was going on in the story and suddenly, you know, he woke up out of the bathtub and he realized ki kuch badal chuka hai. Basically, kya karta hai? Unexpected, the word itself creates curiosity in public. If you see bahut sare TV series, I'll tell you a very live example. Many of you would have, you know, binge watched so many TV series, maybe in your college time or maybe right now you after this book club you might be doing, who knows. People kill their time binge watching the series. And what is binge watching? You keep one episode, and you don't realize you just spent 12 hours of your day just to watch one series. Ab notice karo hua kya hai. Actually, the story created unexpected, you know, ending, which you couldn't resist and you wanted to know more. And that is how it got continued. So to really make your, you know, crowd or make your public to stay with you, it has to, you know, be a little unexpected, and people have to draw towards the end, right? So this also had in my, you know, thing, the C and the C and E and S. The other C is concrete. So whenever, if you saw whatever story I shared, I didn't share abstract. I put details in it. When I told a lady, I mean, usko red gown pehna diya, and I gave you a picture ki she's quite beautiful. She came and she offered a drink and offered a wine. You could actually visualize all those things in your mind just a second. And the story, you know, was a little bit concrete so that you can picturize and the message could pass. So these are three important principles of SUCCESS acronym, which actually will give your idea in a very powerful, you know, anchor, which can help you to communicate and, you know, stick your ideas to many, many people. And the best part is that the book which was written is, if you are curious about the book, it is not my idea. So the guy who wrote this book is Chip and Danhith. Chip is a Stanford grad, a Stanford, you know, PhD guy, who has worked on this concept, you know, how to make your idea stick for almost 10 to 20 years. Friends, sabse best part kya hota hai, you know, you learn from an expert and start implementing rather than you spending 10 years and, you know, finding the same output. So this book is too good. You should also read. If you really read, you'll definitely connect so many dots of your communication message, and it will make your communication super powerful. So this is what I wanted to share, and I'll definitely cover the other CES in the next book club. Hope you'll be there to learn about two more couple of stories. So I'll be talking about a story on Saturn rings. Everyone heard about, you know, solar system. Sabne apna solar system dekha hai. Usme kabhi kisne socha hai ki Saturn ke around ring kyun form hua hai? Aur us ring mein jo bhi cheez bani hai, wo kaise discover kiya? What was the process where, you know, scientists took an effort to, you know, deduce that rings are made of what? So I'll be connecting, I'll be sharing this strong message in the next book club. And thank you so much.
Wonderful sharing, Kiran. The way you related the story with this particular word is too good. Thank you. Who wants to go next?
Madhvi, aapko kuch bolna hai kya? You want to share something, Madhvi? Is she in call?
I think she must be offline. We'll move to the next speaker here then.
Hi and good evening, everyone. Welcome to the book club. I am Supra for new people. I have been with book club Kiran Vijay with quite a long time. And I work as a software professional within BFSI domain for almost like 6 years. I work as a change and a release manager. So that's all about me. And coming to today's topic, I will be talking about everyone communicates and few connect. So before I start this topic, we'll hear something nice. Just now Kiran was explaining a beautiful story and he connected all of you, right? So let's see how we can connect with people through communication. So this particular book by the author John C. Maxwell, he has been one of my favorite author by now. The more I keep touching his books and start reading, I just visualize only Vijay whenever I read this book. The reason is the moment I'm saying this, all things that itself tells that I connected with the speaker, I connected with the author, and something it touched in my personal life and I would have seen around in my environment. Because the moment I am reading the book and I am visualizing the story, the movie, that itself makes I'm connecting with the book and I am trying to recollect few things which I would have observed in my environment. So I would say ideally here, when Kiran was talking about this particular topic, I was really listening to him, but I was thinking that it is very nice if I go next so that I can touch upon and tell the public directly that this is the connecting factor here. Communication doesn't really mean how great accent I speak to you. It all matters how much did you connect with me and understand the message I'm trying to pass you guys. So it doesn't mean that today I'm speaking in front of you and everyone you're understanding. Tomorrow I might be in a crowd. I might be one-on-one with any individual. How impactful that person's brain takes me as an individual is what connecting about. So when I am talking to let me touch on the few principles which the author talks here. The principle could be the first part, as I said, the principle and practices. When you hear this principle and when you put it into action will be practices, which we'll touch on later part. So one-on-one, when any individual talks to an individual one-on-one, you try to connect with the person. How? When you're adding a value to the person's life, how do you add value? It should be very genuine. When you interact with that person, genuinely you praise the person. If you really like the dressing sense of an individual, just tell the person you're dressed up very well. I like it. It is a genuine. It's not like just because I communicated this message, tomorrow you go to someone and try to connect with the person and say that you're really well dressed. And if the person is not, he ideally feels something is fishy, right? So it says in this book that every leader who carries certain important aspects, like what does a leader really carry? A vision to impact the people. He carries a mass with him. So all this capability really not only needs communication skills, it really needs connecting. So to communicate well, connectivity is the key to the communication. So if you are planning, or if you think that you are a leader, or if you want to become a leader, your vision means you there are people along with you who are following along with you, walking along with you to reach that goal. Why are they reaching with you? Because you have connected well with the mass or the group. Maybe one-on-one, maybe an audience, or maybe in a group. So coming to the second principle in the group. So when people are in a group, and let's assume I am the one who is communicating to everyone. So what I do? I generally become a good listener to all of them. I try to really observe every one of them. And I try to speak less about me and try to listen more about them. Ideally, this makes a scenario that the person is very attentive to you and understands. This is one of the very good signs of a good leader. The moment you try to listen someone and know, and you, as we have discussed few personalities, and you get to know about that personality of that individual, you connect with the person, right? So if you observe here one scenario, whatever books we are discussing, those are very closely interrelated with each other. So think if every one by one, when the book I am going through the series and I'm touching, I feel everything is really interrelated. Today, Kiran's topic, I did not know, but it really touched every aspect of what I'm trying and communicating to my audience today. So it made me really easy to come and then connect with all of you. I'm not sure how well I will be connecting, but I make sure that this thing puts a value to your life. So whenever we try to go and attend or address someone, when we are, it could be our friend circle, our spouse. Think, I'm communicating to my spouse and he doesn't understand me. I say something and he understands something. What if I connect with him well? He would not have spoken something and I understand well. It's not only with spouse. It could be your friends, your mom and dad. Even this book also tells there could be a parenting which they do and they're very unsuccessful and they're very sad about that. Their kids are not coming in a very friendly manner to them. Why? Because there is a gap of the connection between them. Ideally, the mom calls a kid and he listens and does the work. But was there a connection? Does he share each and every mischief he does with his parent? If I do that, means I'm connected with my mom. Yeah, I am one of the mischievous person and I do share everything. Means my mom is well connected with me. It's not a credit to me, it's a credit to her. Because she has done her parenting so well that I'm very open to go and say that I have done a mischievous work today. So that is called as the connecting factor. And the third principle which I will be talking is about connecting to a larger audience. Maybe today or you go to a bigger session. Let's take the example of Peak Impact Mentorship. The moment Vijay comes to the stage, he adds a humor in the talks. For what? So that he knows what his audience is. He looks He looks around the public's eye attention. He looks out who is attentive, who is doing what. He needs to know whether his audience or his followers are really interested in this topic, or he should improve a lot, because his book is really going to give him these ideas. Today, whatever he is basically the impact of all these authors we read, and it comes out from there. So when it is about audience, I could only visualize Peak Impact Mentorship, and I could really think how I could be one day like Vijay and connect with people, not communicate. So I communicate in such a way that I connect each and every individual's a single sentence or something which would make the person think, like the way I think that Kiran spoke about a story. Kiran said that particular line, goals. So these are all words. When it is framed inside my subconscious mind, it talks that I do not have to really be conscious in knowing. So it is already in that subconscious mind, which is feeded with positive thoughts, right? So this is actually impacting and connecting with an individual. And I would end my topic here. Thank you so much, everyone.
Wonderful sharing, Supra.
Great sharing, Supra. Kripulaman has a very wonderful story.
Hello, everyone. This is Ripudaman Singh. So today I'm going to share a story of Lijjit Papad. He kaise start hua. So I'm audible.
Yeah.
So 1959 में कुछ औरतें जो मुंबई में रहती थी, गुजराती औरतें, तो उन लोगों ने सोचा कि जब हमारे हस्बैंड ऑफिस चले आते हैं और बच्चे पढ़ने के लिए चले आते हैं, उस टाइम हम लोग अननेसेसरी बैठे रहते हैं, बातें करते रहते हैं, अपना टाइम बेकार करते हैं, तो क्यों ना हम लोग कुछ स्टार्ट करें जिससे हम अपनी फैमिली को एज वेल एज अपने बच्चों को हेल्प कर सकें उनकी ग्रोथ में. सो वो लोग सब लोग अपनी छत में इकट्ठा होते हैं और डिस्कस करते हैं कि क्या करना चाहिए. तो उनमें से एक आइडिया आता है कि क्यों ना हम पापड़ बनाया जाए, कि पापड़ बनाते हैं उसको सेल करते हैं. तो उनमें से एक ने कहा कि ठीक है, मैं सेल करने का मैं काम ले लेती हूँ, मैं बना के सेल कर दिया करूँगी जो भी हुआ करेगा. तो वो लोग जाते हैं, स्टार्टिंग में वो लोग 80 रुपीज बारो करते हैं, किसी से उधार लेते हैं. उसके बाद में वो लोग फर्स्ट डे 1 kg पापड़ बेलते हैं, उससे उनको 50 पैसा, उस टाइम 50 पैसा 1959 में बहुत बड़ी चीज होती थी, तो 50 पैसे जो उनको मिलते हैं फर्स्ट डे, उससे उनको लगता है कि जब हम लोग थोड़ी मतलब 3-4 hours काम करके 50 पैसे इतना ज्यादा अर्न कर सकते हैं, तो क्यों ना और ज्यादा. तो नेक्स्ट डे वो लोग 2 kg बेलते हैं, 2 kg पापड़ बनाते हैं, जिससे उनको 1 rupees मिलता है. तो स्लोली स्लोली वो लोग उसमें और भी औरतें उस मूवमेंट में और भी औरतें जुड़ने लगती हैं, और वो 2 kg से 5 kg, 10 kg, और स्लोली स्लोली उसमें राइट नो इस समय 45,000 औरतें यानी लेडीज जुड़ी हुई हैं, और उनका जो टोटल बिजनेस है वो 3,000 crore का बिजनेस इस समय राइट नो है. उस टाइम किसी ने नहीं सोचा था कि 3,000 crore वो यहाँ तक पहुंच पाएंगे, बट इस समय 17 स्टेट और मोर देन 50 branches दे आर डूइंग दिस लिज्जत पापड़. और इस समय तो वो लोग पापड़ के अलावा अदर चीजें भी बनाने लगे हैं, जैसे कि मसाले और रेडीमेड चपाती, लाइक दैट अदर चीजें बनाने लगे. तो इससे हमें यह सीखने मिलता है जैसे कि उन लोगों ने स्टार्टिंग में छोटी सी एक सोच से इतना बड़ा बिजनेस तैयार कर लिया, उसी तरह जैसे यहाँ पे विजय सर ने पीक इम्पैक्ट मेंटरशिप चालू किया और उसी के थ्रू बुक क्लब, यानी उसी का एक पार्ट है बुक क्लब, ये स्टार्ट हुआ. तो इससे स्लोली स्लोली अगर हम चाहें तो हम लोग पूरे वर्ल्ड को या धीरे धीरे मतलब एक स्टेट से या इंडिया से पूरे वर्ल्ड को यानी ग्रोथ एनवायरमेंट दे सकते हैं. तो this was from my side. Thank you so much.
Very nice story, Ripu. Good evening, everyone. This is Bharat here. So this week I'll be sharing about the third level of leadership. So for past 2 weeks I've been sharing about the first two levels. The first level being, you know, positional, the second being, you know, permission, the third one being the production. So one disadvantage of being a permission leadership is, like, you know, most of the leaders, they tend to become comfortable. Okay, because in permission leadership, they see that, you know, people started to, you know, following them, you know, they become happy. You know, that is because they create a good positive environment around them where everyone feels happy and everyone, you know, wants to be in that kind of an environment. That is a kind of a disadvantage here, actually, because, you know, everyone wants results. Actually, see, environment is good, everything is good, but in the end what matters is, you know,
the work needs to be completed and you know you need results, right? So that is where the production leadership comes into picture, where a production leader, you know, makes sure that he gets what he wants. It doesn't mean that, you know, he'll make people work or anything. He actually realizes, you know, he builds his credibility, he influences people so that, you know, they take up their job seriously and they do the work accordingly. Okay, so that is what a production leader is. For example, I'll tell you this example. Everybody knows McDonald's, right? So actually, McDonald's is founded by two brothers, McDonald brothers actually. They are very good, you know, if you say they are permission leaderships. Okay, so they've created a very good environment around them. Okay, they were successful in the business, but what they were not able to do is they were not able to scale up. They were actually good in their particular, you know, town where they have found this McDonald's. But that is when, you know, Ray Kroc came. He is the guy, you know, who expanded McDonald's to everywhere. That is because, you know, he started working with people closely. So that is when they have started seeing the results. That is when, you know, the profits came up. That is when the turnover, you know, everything went up. So that is what a production leader is, where he clearly differentiates between a permission and a production. Okay. So how do you, you know, identify if there is a production leader around you? As in, we all are in, most of us are in corporates, right? So we work with a lot of leaders. So how do you identify if a leader is in third level? Okay. So there are few pointers. Okay. The first one would be, you know, you would feel like, you know, whatever the leader's professional ability and qualities. Okay. So whenever, you know, a leader is around you, you know, actually respect that particular leader's, you know, responsibilities and whatever work he has done. Okay. So in the next point is so you rely on his advice and, you know, and expertise. Okay. In case if, you know, if a leader around you is giving an advice and expertise, you actually rely on it. And you take that particular, you know, advice and you work on it. In case if you come across that particular kind of a leader, yeah, it is always good to have one. The next one is you have become more productive because of this leader's influence. Okay, in case whatever work that you have been doing and if your productivity has increased because of this particular leader's influence, it means that he is in the particular leader is in the production level. That is level 3. Okay, the team you are part of is more productive because of his or her leadership. Okay, so like I said before, so you start seeing results. Okay, so that is when usually when you are part of a team and your team is doing good, it is most of the time it is because of the leader's influence that who is leading that team. Okay, the next one, last one is you and the team you are part of contribute to the vision and purpose of the organization. Yeah. Like Karthik was telling, you know, he was in a startup where, you know, it couldn't take off. That is because the leadership is not having right vision and, you know, purpose. Okay. If a leader who is at this production level, he usually has a good vision and purpose, which will easily he'll communicate with his entire team members. So that is when you see that, you know, results, you know, going up, you know, profits also, you know, increasing in a particular organization. Okay. So to summarize, so whenever you come across these kind of, you know, qualities where you see that, you know, your leader is encouraging you and he is open in sharing the vision and purpose of the organization that you are part of, you know, always be aware that, you know, he is a growing leader and he is not going to stop at the level 3. Okay. So always be acquainted with those kind of leaders. Thank you.
Awesome, Bharat. It was a great sharing. Great. So we'll hear some more interesting talks now.
Thank you, Bharat. That was really inciting for all of us. I'm Sahana, and I have been referred here by Madhavi. Thank you so much, Kiran and Madhavi. And I'm here to talk one of the very interesting topics. Kiran was sharing something called success. So we all want to be successful. So the main thing for us is we need to work on our inner self. So I'm talking about this book by Ruben Gonzalez called Inner Game of Success. So this book he's a sports person. So Ruben Gonzalez is a sports person. And he's one of the very few Olympians in the luge field. So luge is a game. So if anybody is interested to know more about this game, you should read Courage to Succeed. I connected a lot to this book, like what Supra was sharing, because I am a sports person by nature, so I love games. So I was able to connect a lot to Ruben. So that's why I got an interest to read this book. So he just shares about a couple of success principles. I'll share like 5 to 6 points, and I'll then share a small interesting story after that. So one of the points he shares is refusing to give up on our dreams. Dreams was something that I spoke last week. So anything that really, you know, keeps us going is a strong dream. So something, some obstacle comes up, like Karthik was sharing. He had leadership issues in the team. He did not stop there. He still continuously tried to be there for 2-3 years, then found out a solution. So that was his dream. So he did not refuse to give up on what he was dreaming of. And continuing to that, he was consistent and persistent, because I've seen him for a while. So I know what consistency he maintains in anything that he wants to do or achieve. So that's one of the most important things for any success, any successful person. So yes, we all have the special powers to unlock and attract whatever we want in life. It's just a skill. Our positive thoughts and our, I mean, open-mindedness to learn is something that will lead us to success. And most importantly, our habits and income around, income of the people whom we are around with. So our habits would be something like book reading, a book club. So that will also impact our success levels, and also the income level of people. So if we see probably Bill Gates and Warren Buffett, obviously they have great discussions. So their level of income is much larger. So their positive mindset and keeping things going. You know, at Warren Buffett at this age, he has done a lot. So he's being in one of the top most richest people. So yes, so those people will also impact our success surroundings. And a small story is, I got to read about someone called Krishna Patel. So she's an Indian girl, a 19-year-old who was a passionate mountaineer. So any mountaineer, we all know that they want to get onto the Mount Everest, top of the Mount Everest. But it's one of the most difficult tasks. So her co-mountaineers kept telling her, at this age, why do you have to, you know, go? You can build up your stamina and then come. But all that did not distract her. So she went on the top. And the media has always went up to her family and asked her, why are you letting her do it at this small age? She's still a teenager. So her mom said that I'd rather lose my daughter while doing an accomplishment rather than, you know, just losing her in an accident or just living her life. So successfully she finished the mission. She came down, and our media again went up to her, like, why did you want to do it? What made you to do this? And what mattered? I mean, like, what difference did you see? So she said that while I was at the top of the Mount Everest, it did not matter if I was a 19-year-old, if I was an Indian, I was a girl, but all that mattered was my surroundings was great. So they really helped me succeed and get there on the top. And while we walked back, she said that, you know, thank you for being. So we really need to thank people who let us even give us the smallest point to succeed. Like book club, definitely. I think book reading is something that is totally out of picture for so many people like us. So if we definitely catch along with people or the person who's referred here, it's one of your biggest step to success. So that's the story I wanted to share. So this girl, Krishna Patel, she imagined success to be a realistic thing and not just imagined. And she had a dream. She believed in herself, and with a massive action and with an attitude, to willing to do whatever it takes. And she really took up the step to go back and go up to the Mount Everest, come back and stay successful. And to be frank, she's the only 19-year-old Indian girl who's got into the Mount Everest. And I think we all have an opportunity to pursue our dreams and really plan the mind game that is important to succeed. So this book, I think I've summarized a little more than what I wanted to share. And yes, thank you.
Sharing. Wonderful, Sahana. It was great sharing. I think even I will never forget the youngest lady, Krishna Patel, 19 years old, to, you know, climb the Mount Everest. Great idea stick. Great. Punit?
Hello. Okay. Good evening, guys. My name is Puneet Singh. I work as a mechanical engineer company called IMPL. So everybody started, you know, sharing some of the story, like Kiran, Ripudaman, Sahana, Supra. Even today, I also have one story to share. So last 3 minutes, I'll share you one story, okay? Like, there is two consciousness in our mind, like success consciousness and failure consciousness. So success consciousness always like will win. Come on. Okay. So now today I will talk about like if we have a failure consciousness, like what will happen. So I won't say from which book I have, you know, taken take this story. So I will share. Let me think. Like somebody, if you have read, no, you'll tell the book's name. So there are like two people, a man and his uncle. They went searching for गोल्ड सो उनको पता था कि एक जगह में उधर एक लैंड है उधर नो यू विल फाइंड सम गोल्ड ओवर देयर सो दे स्टार्टेड यू नो अब अगर गोल्ड को डिक करना है तो कुछ मशीन्स चाहिए एंड दे वेंट टू मार्केट एंड दे परचेज्ड ऑल द मशीन्स एंड दे केम टू दैट यू नो बंजर सा लैंड एंड दे स्टार्टेड डिगिंग सो उनको गोल्ड मिल गया हाँ व्हाट दे डिड दे टुक द गोल्ड एंड दे सेल्ड एंड जितना भी वो पैसा था दे स्टार्टेड यू नो रिकवरिंग ऑल द डेब्ट्स दे हैड Then again, they did the same thing until it stopped receiving gold. They stopped receiving gold. So, kya ho gaya? Then they again dig like 5 feet niche, you know, they keep on digging, then they couldn't find. Like that, 5 feet karke, 20 feet unhone dig kiya, they couldn't find any gold over there. So, at the end, what they did, bas ho gaya, bhai, itna khoda, abhi to kuch bhi nahi mila. So, ab kya karte hain, abhi ghar chalte hain. So they took all the machines and they sold very less amount to some other guy. And he asked, ki, you know, what you did with these machines? And they said, ek jagah tha, so we started digging over there. We had some gold over there. We took it and we clear all our debts. Uske baad wahan pe kuch nahi ho, kuch nahi mila. Then that person, he took a civil engineer with him. And he went over there and he like searched all this and then he told 3 feet ke niche na tumko gold mil jayega he started counseling he took everything and he took all the machines again he started digging over there then he found gold then he start taking all those gold and selling he became twice the rich that man which he cleared all the debt the point is everybody you know me everyone will start something you know today aaj kuch start kiya jaise ki exercise whatever it may be we you know do at some point and we just you know theek hai abhi bahut ho gaya then we just go back I think we should not have you know those mind thoughts always we need to have like success consciousness we will succeed not like abhi to ho gaya bas then we go back jitna bhi aapne mehnat kiya na sab pani mein chala jayega Then always have success consciousness, not failure consciousness. So this is my story. Thank you.
Who will tell which book is it?
I know. I know the book name. Who will tell that book name? Anyone who knows the story from which book, they can you know unmute themselves and tell, or you know will reveal the secret. Koi? Anyone in the online? ग्रेट मतलब हम लोग पढ़ाई नहीं कर रहे बुक चल गया दैट इज़ आई डिडंट रीड सो एनीवन वांट टू से व्हिच बुक नो वन हाउ कम नो इट्स वेरी शॉकिंग सी सो द बुक नेम इज थिंक एंड ग्रो रिच तो थिंक एंड ग्रो रिच का बहुत बड़ा कॉन्स्पिरेसी है आई डोंट नो वेदर यू ऑल नो और नॉट बहुत बड़ा कॉन्स्पिरेसी है इनफैक्ट 100 साल पहले जब थिंक एंड ग्रो रिच लॉन्च होने वाला था इनफैक्ट द गाय हु वाज बिहाइंड थिंक एंड ग्रो रिच नॉलेज हिज नेम वाज एंड्रयू कार्नेगी ही वाज रिचेस्ट पर्सन इन दैट एरा वेयर यू नो हेनरी फोर्ड एडिसन ऑल वर देयर एंड दैट गाय वांटेड टू गिव बैक टू सम सोसाइटी वेयर ही कैन रियली एड वैल्यू एंड दैट इज व्हेन ही डिसाइडेड द बिगेस्ट गिफ्ट व्हाट ही कैन गिव टू यू नो हु कैन गिव टू द सोसाइटी इज दैट The knowledge which all of the people or billionaires at that point of time so that, you know, people can really use the knowledge and apply in their life. And what happened, that guy hired this guy called Napoleon Hill, who's, you know, and who's the author of Think and Grow Rich. And then, you know, he started, you know, going to so many, you know, billionaires at the time, John D. Rockefeller, Graham Bell, Edison, Ford, you know, all those people over there. And the moment he started, you know, doing some R&D, he found out a few success principles, which were common across all those people. And the good part was that very few people have a very good background who were, you know, rich from the start. Actually, most of them were, you know, poor in the you know, starting itself. And to validate the information, he also studied 12 to 15,000 unsuccessful people also. So when he say unsuccessful people, it is more of a relative term. He did R&D of all those people. And overall, when he found some success principles, you won't believe it. Can you guess how many years it took for him to really do this R&D? Koi bata sakta hai kya? Anyone? How many years? 20 years, 25 years. That guy invested his 25 years. Ab yahan pe hum log job up kar rahe hain, 20-25 saal bhi kaam nahi karenge. Wo 25 saal bas yahi R&D kar raha tha ki what separates from people who are billionaires or who are struggling for survival in life. And that is when this book of Think and Grow Rich was, you know, formed. It is a tremendous book. Uske baad, in fact, the moment the book was formed, now Andrew Carnegie was super excited. He wanted, you know, all schools should read it. All children should read it. Because every curriculum mein is book hona hi chahiye. Because the moment we go into school curriculum, the fundamental book is used where we can really shape our life. You know, in spite of reading all those mathematics, science, which is using in our corporate, maybe job or something. How do we shape our life or our, you know, overall, you know, journey? And that guy wanted badly that ki jaake school curriculum mein. But fir kya hua? Government ko pehle validate karna tha. Government gaya, validate karne gaya. Tab pata chal gaya government ko sab sachchai. He realized ki agar ye book agar bachcho ko pata chal gaya, and when children read this book, then world will grow so fast. So we shouldn't let that happen. We should create more labors. So let the book would not go to the school curriculum. आप विश्वास नहीं करोगे ऐसा हो गया. एंड द मोमेंट दैट हैपेंड अब तक इनफैक्ट आई डोंट थिंक एनीवन वुड हैव रियली रेड दिस बुक इन एनी ऑफ द स्कूल. इवन आई डिडंट रीड इन माय स्कूल नॉर इन माय आईआईटी एनीवेयर आई डिडंट रीड. बट वेयर डिड आई फाउंड आउट दिस बुक? आई फाउंड दिस बुक विद वन ऑफ द बिलियनेयर एंड मिलियनेयर. एंड एवरी बिलियनेयर, एवरी गाय हु यू नो इज इन द करंट एरा प्रमोट्स दिस बुक इन टॉप 10 ऑफ हिज कैटेगरी. दैट इज द पावर ऑफ दिस बुक. And apart from this book, there's also other book. Definitely, I'm sure बहुत लोगों ने पढ़ा नहीं होगा. इसके ऊपर भी बहुत बड़ा conspiracy हुआ है. In fact, जो लोग गलत time में invest करते हैं, जो लोग you know गलत time में गलत जगह spend करते हैं. In fact, if you see many people जो अमीर बन जाते हैं, maybe 5 साल में अमीर बने, फिर पता चला 5 साल के बाद again you know square one. The biggest example if you see currently is I think one was Theranos, the company called Theranos, where the lady was from Stanford grad. And she took her company from ground zero to almost maybe $42 billion in the net worth. And within next 5 years, all vanished. You can just Google it out. There's another company called WeWork. I think this you must have already heard. WeWork ka jo founder hai, usne jab start kiya tha, aur abhi wo kick out ho chuka hai. WeWork ke founder, you know, director team mein. WeWork is also going in losses. The fundamental book to, you know, understand your basic finances. And the author who wrote this book also, he also wrote few more books with Donald Trump. He's not a small guy, he's a tremendous value addition guy. And iske liye aapko koi, you know, finance ka graduation major kuch nahi karna hai. Aapko bas English padhna aana chahiye. And if you can visualize what he's talking, that's it. And that author talks about, you know, his rich dad, jo mera baap ameer tha, jo mera baap, you know, jo mera normal baap tha, jo Stanford ka PhD tha, unke aur mera ameer baap ka thought pattern mein difference kya tha. And that guy, again, wo jab banda ne book publish karne ka socha tha, har publisher mana hi nahi. Every publisher, when he went to publish the book, every publisher told, no, we can't publish this information. This information cannot go. We don't want everyone to become wealthy. You know, let us keep it very simple. And this happened in the year of 1998. Author Robert Kiyosaki was struggling, you know, how he can pass on this message to people. But you know what is the beauty? That book passed on with just referrals. Ki ek bande ne padha, you know, dusre bande ne promote kiya. Aise aise karte karte 20 saal mein that book is a one number one bestseller. I think more than 50 million copies has been sold, and still it is tremendously, you know, promoted across people who really want to understand and set right the basic finances. So, dosto, the reason we are promoting all this book is very simple. We all wanted to be get empowered, and we wanted to share this knowledge. Hum log actually bahut sari cheeze share karte hain.
कोरोना वायरस आ गया उसकी इतना शेयर किया है, वाई डोंट वी शेयर समथिंग यू नो गुड फॉर पीपल ऑल्सो, ताकि लोगों का कुछ भला हो जाए. सो And the best part is that, in fact, I think few days back, I saw Bharat and Supra also, you know, started implementing their learnings. They started, you know, Bharat was talking about leadership, Supra was talking about connecting. Both of them, you know, together, whatever they learned, the best part, they started applying wherever their, you know, interest is. They are interested in, you know, health. They started touching to lots of gyms and health club and all those people and started sharing the expertise. And why don't you guys share if you want to share the journey a little bit, and we'll end there. That.
So I just would like to add, Bharat is a very fitness freak. I'm always very happy that, yeah, I always wanted a person who should never make me, I'm ideally not a lazy person, but it generally happens after you're back from office and all, you don't feel like working out. But I'm also a person who loves, but he is a person who puts that add-on tadka, right? Agar thoda bhi wo man nahi ho raha na, No, you have not worked out and you have to do. So you actually need a person like that in your life who makes you push for your workout. Because health is one of the biggest pillar among the five pillars which we know. We only think money, but not only money. Health is the other aspect. Paise ka kya karoge if you're already bimar and in the deathbed, right? So I am very happy that he always motivates and inspire people around him always for fitness things. And he really goes and gives the Sunday park event for all of us. So we get to learn new exercises and everything. So yeah, I'm really walking in this journey with him. So I'm very happy about it.
Yeah, I mean, I would like to share the event that we attended yesterday. Like, we both went to a gym event and we just shared whatever knowledge we have about, you know, nutrition. So that was a nice session where, you know, Supra also helped me. So that's all.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Bharat. It was great. So guys, we are end of today. In case I think few of the new people are there, you guys can unmute yourself and introduce if you want to. I think there are a couple of 2 to 3 people who are still there. Asha, are you online? Asha is your Puneet's mom. Wow, that's awesome. There is too much, too inspiring. Great. Asha ji, bolenge kya? Puneet? Okay. We'll call next time. Next is Sher Banu. Sher Banu, can you unmute yourself? Sher, you can speak in case you're audible. Okay. I think you're audible. You're finding some disturbances, I guess. I think he is out. Let Anil, can you hear me? Anil, I think Anil also is new. I'm not sure whether he's around. I think rest of who is Oppo F1? I forgot. Himanshu, hai kya? Oppo F11. Great. Anyway, so friends, what you can do is promote this book club a lot, because people need growth environment, and let's bring people here to grow so that we all can help each other. And see you next week. Bye-bye.